Member of the Year by People's Choice. Come on, give it up for her. Carolyn, I can't say enough about what you do for BOCI through your business, the Fashion Academy. Would you elaborate on what your involvement has been with us through collaboration and how it has affected your business? And then I would like for, we had several people vote for you, but I would like for Lazarus to come up behind you and comment on, in fact, Lazarus, why don't you come up with us now and comment on why you voted for Carolyn Bendel.
I put him on the spot last night too, and he came through.
I voted for Carolyn because I had met her doing a music video. My partner Kent had known her and said we needed to bring her in and help us with the look of our artist and the character he'd be portraying in the video. And I watched, I have a tendency to sit back and watch people before I actively interact with them. I like to observe a little bit about their behavior. And I watched as she very openly was honest and straightforward, very helpful, very clear and articulate with our artist, telling him what it was he needed to do, why he needed to do it, and able to make him understand it in a way that he didn't feel that he didn't already look good. It wasn't a case of he made him feel bad about how he did look. It was very clear that what she was attempting to do was help him go from how he was to how he wanted to be as he presented himself to an audience at large. And the professionalism and the attitude that we encountered on set was, in my eyes, was golden. I loved you immediately. So.
That's amazing.
That was
Thank
an
you.
Easy vote for me.
Thank you. And Lazarus will be introducing you a little later with what you do. We're so happy to have you here.
Thank you.
Carolyn, share next week.
Yes! Tell us about Cher. Tell us about your involvement and what you do, Carolyn.
Well, what I do for Cher.
For Cher and for your business.
Oh, okay. Well, next week for Cher, we're bringing in, you hear a lot about Memphis wanting to bring in film. I mean, we had that TV show about Memphis cops that was filmed in New Orleans. Hello. So we hear a lot about trying to bring those types of things into Memphis. And what we don't always hear is how it benefits you, the business world. And so we're bringing in Lynn Sittler with the Shelby County Film Commission. And she is going to talk to you about how your business can benefit and how maybe collaborations can be made between you and the Film Commission. Then Lazarus will be speaking on specifically the videos and movies and things that he has done and how other businesses, not even associated with movies or anything, are brought in to help. And then we will also have Lisa Bird Thomas, who is the costume designer for the Grace Card. If you have not seen that yet, it is a must. And it's about two Memphis police officers. And she is going to talk about the collaboration efforts that she had to use that brought in businesses for just making this movie. So I hope you all come and spread the word. Lynn Sittler is a wonderful speaker. If you've not heard her, she's a really, really good speaker. So that's Cher.
When is Cher?
Cher is 1 week from right now. Right here, 9 o'clock next week, okay? Thursday at 9 o'clock. So be here, have your business cards ready, have your ready to take notes, and so you can know where and how you can help also in that effort, okay? Now, I want to touch on this.
Tell everybody what it is.
I'm not member of the year. I don't. I'm always a back row person. I don't get this. Yes. I'm at a loss. I don't know what to say, but thank you.
We love you, Carolyn.
But Fashion Academy, what we do, and I just really had a strong feeling just over the last couple of weeks about more about what we do. A lot of people, we do train image consultants. We train them to be able to do things like Lazarus mentioned, or Lisa Thomas is one of our image consultants. She did costuming for a movie. And so doing those types of things is what we do. But what from my heart really truly is to help people feel better about themselves. And to know it's not you, it's the designer's idea of an unreal body shape. Because that's just what we do. And that's where I feel, because we've got a very damaged society who thinks that they have got to be this one certain thing, and you can't be that one certain thing. It's not there. It just isn't there. And so that's what we do. We train image consultants. We do have people all over the world. And then that opens up a lot of doors for us in a lot of other ways. And then for Sherry, I just did what comes naturally.
Yes, you did. And you
did. So thank you. Thank you so much, Sherry. And I'm
thank
totally
people's
blown
choice.
Away.
People's choice. One short thing as to why I was so glad the people chose Carolyn, because we went through a very difficult time last year with our daughter, Sarah. Sarah, wave everybody. We're so happy Sarah's here. She could be
not here.
Not here. And very much so. And so it was very long and lengthy, and I called Carolyn and I said, look, Carolyn, I'm not able to do all of these events, and I'm calling on people that I know have integrity and I know will take care of things that need to be taken care of. And I was wondering if you would like to take over the BOCI Share event for the next few months. And she didn't ask any questions. She just said, Sherry, whatever you need, I'm there to do it. She didn't say, what am I gonna get paid? How long am I gonna do it? That's all she said. That meant the world to me. Thank you for being you. All right, well, I would like for us to all get to know one another a little, and I want to introduce our first time guest, Melissa James. I've known you in passing on social media for some time now, and then we met a few months ago in my office. And so would you stand and tell everybody who you are and what you do?
Well, I'm Melissa James. Nice to meet you back. Glad to be here for the first time. Had said we've met many times, but I haven't actually been to an event, so I'm excited to be here. I'm with Trans World Systems. Essentially, we are a collections company, but basically what they decided to do was to put a program in place to prevent companies from ever having to send clients to collections. So we basically work to help put your money in quicker, faster, without having to take a percentage of your money and do it for a low flat rate per account. So that's essentially what I do, is work with companies to help increase the cash flow.
Think
that's a connection for you?
Yeah, we've been discussing that.
It's so good to have you here. I was, my husband and I are having a sidebar conversation over here. So. And we also have Sydney here, who is a friend of the family, very good friend of Sarah's. And would you stand and tell us what your new venture is and why you came out today?
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Sydney. I am brand new to this whole business world. I was in retail management for about 4 years. I grew up in retail, owning businesses, my family, yada, 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 yada. I quit my job and went on a leap. It did not go well. And so I thought, well, why don't I start my own business? I'm a smart girl, got some business training in me, so I'm going to start a comfort food truck in Memphis. Hopefully, we got it going soon. I'm currently in the whole ball rolling money venture part, but there's not a whole lot of places in Memphis, especially in business areas, where you can go get a home cooked meal, much less a home cooked meal that might have less butter, might have something for vegetarians, is not full of bacon and fat and grease and mess. So I want to provide a home cooked meal on the go for businesses.
I like that.
And my mom went to cooking school in London at Cardona. So I do.
That's awesome. It's great to have you here, Sydney.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
We have a few more guests. I see a couple here in the back. It's so good to have you come in. Would you introduce yourself?
Good morning. My name is Grace Major. Actually, I joined earlier this week.
You sure did.
I
saw you online. Welcome. New professional member, everybody.
Yes. Shelly Bauer is the one that's been tugging and pushing and saying, Grace, you really need to talk to this before. So I said, you know what? She's gave me great recommendations before.
Yes.
I could follow a couple weeks. And I thought, you know what? I'll take the lead. I drug my husband out, Craig Major.
Mm-hmm.
So we're here this morning. Glad to be here.
It's so good to have you here, Grace Major. I love that. Sounds
what
amazing.
Do I do?
Thank you. My
husband and also, Craig, what do you do? That's a question in the audience.
The service that I provide is I help students with public speaking, leadership skills, and organizational skills. I focus on youth and teens to get them prepared to go out and meet the real world and to develop life skills that will help them to be successful. We also have a real estate business that we run out of Bartlett. I'll let my husband explain that.
Please do. Craig.
Good morning. My name is Craig Major. Me and Grace run Triangle Properties out of Bartlett. We buy single-family homes, mostly in the Cordova, Arlington, Lakeland area, some in Bartlett. And we have some small multi-unit properties in the downtown, midtown area. And we've been in business for about 8 years. And Grace assists me in running that company.
We're so glad to have you here. And there's two chairs right up here. If you'd like to come on up and have a seat.
In front of the room.
There you go. Or you can sit those chairs. Okay, I would like to introduce Pastor Renee. And I don't know your last name, Renee.
Smith.
Renee Smith, who has absolutely gorgeous jewelry over in the corner. She is coming on as a new professional member and has rented a booth. I just bought this from her a week ago. It's absolutely gorgeous. She has beautiful jewelry, so make sure you stop by over there. Tell us what you do, why you're here, what made you come out today.
Okay, first of all, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Didn't have the opportunity to greet anyone. But thank you so much, Sherry, for inviting me. I am Renee Smith, and as you said, I am an assistant pastor of Empowerment of Faith. This is one of my businesses that I do. It's my goal to empower men and women and to prosper. This business, I've been doing this almost about a year, and I'm loving the bling bling of it, mm-hmm. and of course the money that it's producing for our family. And also, we also do real estate. We have a construction company as well, have 6 children, and we have a big house, and it's still not big enough. So, yeah, so I love what I do, and I love helping people, and I'm just thankful that I was able to connect with you.
And we met through Loretta McNary's
right.
show, which shows uh-huh. you how collaboration works. So
yes.
thank you for being here.
Thank
We're
you.
Glad to have you.
Okay.
And we have a new member in the crowd, Melinda, who is a part of Talk Shop. She joined at 50% off because if you are an advertiser with Talk Shop, I want you to check them out. They meet every Wednesday morning. If you advertise with them, then you get membership for the first year with us, professional membership for $50. Melinda, would you stand and tell us why you decided to go ahead and join BOCI?
Well, I've heard good things about you, and in my schedule, one of the things was looking this year very focused on developing some new things. About a year ago, I got introduced to a product called Plexus Slim. At that point in time, I was about 45 pounds heavier and in a size 18. And I did not pay attention when the lady, who was pastor's wife down in Akron, Mississippi, actually told me about it. I knew about it about 9 months before that, then went, okay, I'm not gonna do anything. But then I saw her. And what happened for me is it really changed my life, which gave me a passion. Two things. One is, I see a lot of people who are not healthy. I know for myself, I thought there's really no hope. But what I saw was, we developed something called Making Memphis Slim, one person at a time. We were at the fair, and we have about 70 people who started taking this. We got some tremendous health stories. My best one is a young man that's 42 years old, whose blood sugars have gone down from like 380 to 130 on average. And it is amazing. The real passion I have is that we have a lot of people with lower incomes who are very, very unhealthy. And what I'd like to do is connect professional women with a low-income lady and teach them about direct selling and health at the same time so that we can not only empower them with their health, but with their finances.
I love that. Thank you so much for sharing that.
So I came here to meet people with social media to help us get our story out.
Absolutely. We'll be talking more about what Cheryl does, one of our Professional Boost members. We have a Professional Boost alumni, Beverly, wave at everybody, who just graduated. If you need to know more about our Professional Boost nonprofit program, you can see me to talk about that. But Beverly has jewelry over there. She makes specially designed jewelry that is handmade by her. So make sure you drop by and check that out. Now, let's see, did I miss any first-time guests? Okay, everybody else is old-timer? Okay, Donna Kirk, we have not seen you in a while, so I would like you to tell us, you've done, I believe, a change in your venture, what you're doing. Would you tell us about your new venture, Donna?
Put me on the spot. A little bit about me. I was an interior designer in Memphis for 15 years, and of course, everybody knows what the economy did. And then I lost the use of my hand, and I got sick. So I had gone into trying to find a way to get back on my feet without taking any type of prescription drugs. So what I'm doing now is I'm still with the Gene Me, but what I've been able to do is research more into each different type of wellness company. And I haven't even told anybody what I'm doing yet. Cherry doesn't even know, but I am in the process of working on a website, and it's gonna be Donna, the go-to girl. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna allow people to send references to, you know, things that they would like for someone to review and do it in a professional manner. And it's kind of like Andy Wise, okay, but on a larger scale for wellness. Does it work? What are the benefits? Because there's a lot of things. Wellness companies are not regulated by the FDA, so they pretty much can do whatever they want to do. And so we're trying to educate everyone as to what is the best supplement for you, because each person is individual. So that's kind of what I'm doing now. So
well,
we let the
forward
cat
to
out of the
that
bag.
Yeah. Yes, thank you so much. All right, I would like real quick for you to raise your hand, tell me what it is that you expect to receive. One word, one adjective that you expect to receive out of today. Somebody needs to start.
Information.
Good. What else?
Collaboration.
Customers.
Okay, keep going.
Relationship.
There you go.
Okay.
Business tool.
That's two words.
All right.
Okay.
You know me. I know all the rules.
Okay. Keep going.
Blogging help.
Blogging? All right. Good. We're covering all of this. We will be covering today. Every bit of it. Awesome. Blogging help. Good deal. Now, what I'd like you to do is stand up, find somebody you have not talked to yet, and spend 2 minutes networking.
Beverly.
Yeah.
So what do you do? You make all this yourself?
I don't make it. I'm an independent consultant of Tracy Lynn Jewelry. We're based in Fort Lauderdale. Hello. And I sell jewelry, and then I'm looking for business partners in Memphis. I have some in Georgia as well. And the benefits are phenomenal.
So this is a franchise company that you represent, but then with your ministry, are you using, I wanted you to know that I'm Deborah Norwood. I'm an attorney in Linden and Past Jackson.
Yes.
In our area, we have a ministry going on where the proceeds for the jewelry are going to women who are victims of rape and you know, other domestic violence.
Right.
So I was just wondering if you had any kind of a link like that. I'd love to let you know about this other lady that we have out in our area, because it sounds like she's also got a ministry, but she's not a minister. And maybe there's something that you guys could do together.
Oh, I have one of my cards. I can give that to you.
Because it sounds like you have two things going on.
I have several things going on.
Yeah. So as a minister, are you using the proceeds from your business, or is this your private business to keep you financially?
This is my private business.
Gotcha. Well, this is beautiful.
Thank you, isn't it, Beverly?
Now, Beverly, I purchased some things for Beverly. Beverly makes beautiful things. She hand makes them to order, you know, to your. But this display here, I'm going to take a picture of it. This display here is for what Carolyn Bendel at Fashion Academy would say is a dramatic. These are definitely dramatic. If you don't mind, I'm going to go ahead and. I know that the tech team will be taking lots of pictures, but this is always non-professional Facebook stuff.
Okay.
But Carolyn Bendel is another person that I think you might enjoy meeting. Carolyn is a business partner of mine, and she is an image
Mississippi biscuits back there.
Thank you.
We're looking forward to speaking with you.
Everyone has a seat, please. The next portion of what we are doing is rolling out the people's choice. I need a drum roll. All right. Collaborator of the year 2012 is Rising Fire Productions. And that is Lazarus, you are the first person I met, then Marcus, then Jamie, and I can see that you all work very well as a team. And I'm so excited. And see, I'm excited. You don't know what I'm excited about. Like, I know what I'm going to say before you do. So I know about the collaboration that we're doing, that we're getting ready to roll out for everybody. But first, I just want to thank you for the collaboration efforts that we did last year with the BOCI, actually Business Over Coffee TV pilots. We've done two so far. This year, we're going to be doing 8 more. We will have 10 upscale TV pilots in the can.
Sherry, I have a comment.
To move forward. And I would like you and Deborah to come forward and talk about this.
No, Lynn Sittler told me.
You're fine.
On the phone. Before we even talked on the phone, she went online to check out BOCI, and she said, that TV show is fantastic.
And they did it. They did it.
Yes, it is.
Absolutely. Because anyone that is behind a microphone or a camera, B.W.Burnett over there, you know that a microphone can make or break you. The audio,
exactly.
It absolutely. Same thing with the camera. And so we could have come in and had the most incredible content, and you guys could have taken that, and it wouldn't have been that great. You made us look really good. You spoiled me. That's all I can say. Okay, and we're going to tell you how they can do that for you as well. But first, I would like for Deborah to come up as well, Deborah Norwood, and comment on your relationship with Rising Fire.
Yes. I definitely had to vote for Rising Fire as the collaborators of the year because, as I had kind of briefly mentioned to you before, my company, Laughter Lawyer, is tangential to Fashion Academy. Through Fashion Academy and Carolyn Bendel as a business partner, I've learned how to help corporate professional settings, people that are interested in being professional have learned how to be so grim when they're professional. And so she lightened me up and brought color into my life. And because I'm a certified laughter person, I've decided to bring color and laughter into Carolyn's company. And between the two of us, we decided to partner in a radio show that was done through BOCI, and it's called Look Good, Feel Good. Well, it was through the radio show, through Carolyn, through Sherry, that I was then connected to Rising Fire. And Rising Fire did the most wonderful, wonderful video and television presentation of our companies. As a result, we had a person from the Commercial Appeal there, and I ended up having an article in the Commercial Appeal. I am so grateful to Carolyn, to Sherry, and to Rising Fire because of what you've done for my company.
Thank you. Very well. Can we get a photo op?
Yeah.
Collaborator of the year?
No.
All right.
And Laughter Lawyer has a gift for Rising Fire as well.
Oh, you go ahead and present that while I get a picture with member of the year.
As you know, all of us are entitled to have a happy childhood, and some of us may not have had a happy childhood, so we may have to regroup and relearn how to laugh and how to giggle and how to be childish, and thank you so much. Someone gifted that to me, and there's something just absolutely insane about it, and I want to give it to you as a reminder to lighten up and keep us going.
Cocktails. All right.
Well, I had a demented childhood, so this carries it on well.
Now, Marcus, you were the one that did the editing process, and you're like the brains, I guess.
He's definitely the
brains. Okay, the tech person. So tell us what all goes into doing these television shows.
That editing that was actually a lot of fun because we had 5 live microphones that I had to pull sound from. It was 70% of the edit was actually audio, actually. And you know, the cutting the video together, doing color corrections, not that big deal. That audio was a chore because I had to cut out microphones, add microphones, add sound, and it was a daunting task. I think each episode I put in 10 to 12 hours for each 30-minute episode.
24 hours worth of editing. Thank you so much for taking that much time to make this look good. You can find these TV shows we're talking about on our site, businessovercoffee.biz, and one is called Bridging the Gap from Success to Influence, and the other is called Feel Good, Look Good. And Jamie, let's talk about, you and I are meeting this coming Monday to go over some things about BOCI Talk Radio, drum roll. So tell us what's getting ready to happen.
I'm getting ready to be a part of my own radio show for BOCI.
Cool.
I'm going to talk about what it is for production in your business. How we as a company, what we want to do for you as making anything that you do with us and a part of your business, one of the best media options that you have, whether it be for television, whether it be for social media, or if you want to put it in the movie theaters. We're going to make it to where it's clear, it's comfortable, and it looks and sounds great. And give you a little bit of background about what that takes to do something like that, from the idea to the production, pre-production, production, and then post-production as well. To give you a better understanding, it is what we do for you to branch your business out, and the importance of getting something that's clear and sounds good, like you were talking about before. Just making you look good, making your business look good, and you'll be able to promote yourself more.
I love that. That's great. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
And that will be launching the first week in February on a Friday, your
yes,
show.
Ma'am.
Do you know what time you plan to?
That was one of the things that we were going to talk about Monday.
All right.
That is the time, so getting it all worked out. So.
All right. You will be hearing more about that. All right. And now, last but not least, let's talk about the major collaboration that is taking place with BOCI / Rising Fire Productions. I was thinking to myself, we invested in some new equipment, tech team's doing a fabulous job, and we have our one-on-ones where we sit down with our professional members and we do our live interviews. However, for an upscale television show that's TV ready, we thought about, Richard, not wait, everybody, it's my husband Richard over here. We thought about, you know, investing into the right things to make that happen. And one night I was just thinking to myself, why reinvent the wheel if there's someone out there already doing it?
Right.
Let's at least sit down and talk about it. It's the true sense of collaboration. So your spirit, listen to the show of Lazarus we had on BOCI Talk Radio, where he talks about the spirit of people and giving and collaboration and all that. So we sit down, you and I, and Marcus, and then you pulled Jamie into the conversation later on. I wasn't privy to that, but you all made a consensus that and agreed that we would all be in collaboration with Upscale TV. Tell us more about it.
I don't really know much about the Upscale TV side of it, to be honest with you. Kent mentioned to me that I had the emails because I affectionately refer to myself as techno-target. I ignore my computer as much as I possibly can in every aspect. I do as much things on paper as I possibly can work out. But he told me I had emails that I had to respond to, and one of them was you wanting us to come in and help you bring this BOCI television show to a wider audience to really, really help your business and the businesses you are representing get attention. And, you know, having worked with you, having met you, that was enough for me. I knew that we could be a part of that. It was just a matter of figuring out how we could make that happen. As Jamie said, pre-production, post-production, all of this is time-consuming. Time is money.
Yes.
And as Kent indicated, you know, he spent 10 hours just to get one half-hour show. So we had to balance it against what kind of profit margin are we looking at, things like that. And we're basically donating our time to you for this production, because if we can help show your audience and your team of people that are under the BOCI banner what a good production can do for them, then that's good for our business. So this is an advertising opportunity for us. It's a chance for us to basically just show the world what it is we do for your business. And I was explaining to one or two people what that is. I have 12 years of experience doing film. He has multiple years of experience doing just about anything you can think of with a camera, as does Kent, in front of the camera, behind the camera, post-production, pre-production, whatever it is. Between us, we have 28 years of experience. And we figured we bring that to small businesses. In Memphis, there are two big companies, and neither one really wants to take an advertising job less than $10,000. Who in this room can afford a $10,000 commercial? So we wanted to bring the smaller businesses the opportunity to compete with the corporate world as far as their advertising dollar yes. goes. I spent 12 years making multiple movies on almost nothing. My first film was made on $4. We've made a film on $50. We've made a film on nothing.
Right, right.
So we really practiced and learned the art of high production value at low to no cost.
So when you hear collaboration in conjunction with Rising Fire Production, what does that mean to you? What that means to you is that you as a business owner or over a group, if you want to come in and hire a team in Memphis to do a TV show for you, a 30-minute episode, we now have the capabilities in conjunction with Rising Fire to make that happen for you. You get it at 20% off of their normal costs when coming through us. We provide the venue right here through Ridgeway Business Center, and we're going to have Virginia talk about that, who's over Ridgeway. So this is a major, major step for us. What do you guys think?
Outstanding.
Wow. Yes. Thank you so much. How about giving it up for the collaborators of the year? Yes, they have to go to work.
And I've got to start dealing with clients and emails and all the stuff.
Thank you for coming. I appreciate it.
And thank you very much for this, for anybody and everybody that voted for us.
Yes,
absolutely. One more picture, photo op.
Can you pass out business cards before you leave?
Sure can.
Yes.
Okay, big smile.
All right, as Shelly is getting those pictures, we're going to move on to the next portion. Cheryl Hurley, would you come up? I would like to introduce Cheryl. Cheryl is the epitome of the word professional and the stylist quo. You've probably seen a lot of quotes about Cheryl. Come on this side over here. Cheryl is one of our Professional Boost members, and she makes us look good because she is fabulous at what she does. She is piloting the BOCI blog program. Now, one of the things I heard was information, another I heard was customers, another I heard was connections, another I heard was blogging help. Cheryl brings all of that to the table with the new program we have just rolled out, the BOCI Member Blog Program. Once you've gone through this, or if you choose to use this particular program, which is a lower rate, then you look at the upscale programs that that Cheryl has through the Stylist Quo. She can take you, the sky's the limit. You go.
Right. So we really want to encourage the BOCI members to get involved on social media, and that goes beyond just tweeting every now and then or posting what you're doing on Facebook. When you provide a blog, you're providing all of this content to bring customers to you, to get to know you and to trust you. And when people get to know you and trust you and your product is good, they're going to become customers. So to encourage that, we're offering a program that is at a it's a pretty good discount right now, so that we can encourage you guys to be a part of that. So we provide one blog per month or two blogs per month. And what that means is we're going to work together to make it into going from just your information and your expertise to a blog that's entertaining and informative to read. You are the expert, so I don't want to write it all for you. You know, you don't want me like telling people how to do color analysis, okay, because I don't know how to do that, right? So I'm going to take your expertise and turn it into a blog. So that's the overview of the BOCI blog program. And as Sherry said, I run a social media marketing and management consulting firm, so I can provide pretty much anything beyond this for you. We work together on an individual basis to develop a program that will work best for you, for your industry, and for your customers, and it can grow your business. It's really reaching customers where they are. You know, people aren't looking at billboards anymore. They're not watching commercials. You know, people develop very intricate ways of avoiding commercials and avoiding advertisement. So reaching them on Twitter and Facebook and Pinterest and all of those places, that's where they are, and that's where you need to be. So that's my spiel.
That's your story you're sticking to?
Yeah.
Okay.
And if you want to talk to me about any of this, I'll be around.
Yes, thank you so much. Also, I'd like to mention that Cheryl will be with us at the BNI International Networking Week, which you'll be hearing more about here in the next hour. We only have 55 more minutes, and lots of information to pack into that time. But you will be with me and our entire tech team. Tech team, would you stand, wave at everybody so everybody can see who you are, what you do? Yes, yes. We'll all be there. There's going to be 300 or more people, and maybe even up to 500 at this event. Cheryl will be blogging at that event. Cheryl is blogging this event. So if you're having an event and you'd like somebody to come out and blog your event, that's the new PR. Everybody say that. Blogging is the new PR.
Blogging.
All right, there you go. Am I not doing it? That check afterwards?
Direct deposit, Sharon.
All right, and she has great, you might want to just pass these around so everybody gets
some.
Yeah,
if you're interested, I have a few flyers. I don't have like 50.
Well, why don't you just pass them around for people to look at?
Oh, okay,
that
right,
would
right.
work. All right, and pass this around as well. This is Talk Shop. You can find one of those up here at the table as well. And let me ask you, does anyone have any questions for me about BOCI and what our professional membership is? Shelley Bauer just walked in. Would you come up so you can elaborate on the professional membership?
Always put me on the spot.
All right, so you take over right here.
Okay, so the professional membership, for those of you who are not, raise your hand if you're not already a professional member. Okay, one, two. Okay, good. So I'm going to speak to you because everybody else is a professional member. For $100, a measly $100 a year, I mean far, far less than a cup of coffee a day, you can be a professional member. And what that does is it gives you access to everything that This Is Over Coffee is doing online and offline, but you also get, is it now up to 8 services?
Six services.
So the services include things like website analysis, social media campaign analysis. I mean, things that can really let you know where you are so that you benchmark where you are and can measure what it's going to take along the way to get you where you want to be. You also get an audio, a radio show with Sherry, a television show with Sherry. I mean, it's...
And we have over 5,000 listens a month now on
that's
radio,
right.
So that's great exposure.
That's right, over 5,000 listens a month now on radio. So if all you're doing is taking advantage of the freebies that are available to you as a professional Boost member, you are getting a far higher return on your investment than any other $100. Can I get an amen on that?
I want to add one thing, Shelly. We just gave the option that if someone wants to pay $10 a month, of course it's going to be $20 more a year, right, to become a professional member, then you can do that by signing the automatic withdrawal, recurring debit, okay? And we can set that up for you to where the $10 will automatically come out of your account and you'll be a professional member that way as well.
Perfect, if cash flow is an issue.
That's
anybody
right.
in here as a small business owner have a cash flow problem? Never mind.
Thank you. All right, now we are going to, drum roll. All right, we're going to a very special person I've been following for some time, our first speaker today. We have 20-minute spots for speakers, so we have Pastor B.W.Burnett, who is going to tell us about your business and his community service and what we're doing here at BOCI by giving you these options to give back to our community. So welcome Pastor B.W.Burnett and his lovely wife, pastor's wife, Clarissa Burnett. It's been nice to get
that. Thank you so much, Lester, for that warm introduction. Can we give it back to Sherry? She's done an amazing job bringing a group of professionals such as yourselves together as our power of networking and collaboration. That's what we need in this economy that we're currently operating in. As we see ourselves transitioning from a W-2 society to a 1099, what's happening here right now is much needed. Now, to tell a little bit about myself, I'm a pastor right here in the Memphis area. I was born and raised here in Memphis, but not always lived here. I joined the military during the Vietnam era and left Memphis and was born for over 34 years. And coming back to the city that I was born in, and it was a very different city at that time, I'm still trying to adjust, okay? But my ministry is located in the Orange Mound community, which is a historically black community, but it's also known as a stress community in that it's a lot of low-income people, and of course a lot of the problems go with an absence of money, as you all know. And our ministry had been thriving with a lot of different programs, social programs, that we were reaching out to the residents of that community to try to assist them with food, with clothing, with making computers accessible to the children, that we can help them with their homework, because the reading skills are really just the worst I've ever seen. And of course, there were a lot of other issues in the community with domestic violence and things like that. So we had a large ministry that was thriving, but when the economy went bottom up, we saw something happen that really just took the wind out of sails. And we had to shut down a lot of our programs that were much needed because of funding. And I struggled with that for a long time. And I'm still very passionate about that today because the needs of the people are great. And it's hard to do ministry when people are hungry. It's hard to do ministry when the lights are out. It's hard to do ministry when there's no clothes or food and the babies are crying, you know. So a lot of the programs that we shut down, we try to network with other individual ministries and organizations to continue that, but we just had to shut a lot of those programs down, and that was hard to do. And so we began, my wife and I, to look for other means of trying to have income coming in so that a lot of those programs, we can keep them going. And we tried a lot of different things that really was just too expensive to do. Until a gentleman walked in my office one day and presented a magazine to me of this company that was allowing people to invest a small amount of money and over a course of time build an income stream from bills that are being paid. And I was really shocked by that. So I want to just share that with you, how my ministry now benefits that every time somebody turns a light on, cooks a meal, takes a bath, or looks at TV, uses a telephone, cell phone, internet, that we actually get a return just from them paying a bill. And the best part of that is that we show them how to save money on the bills that they're paying anyway. And so I want to tell you about our company and our ministry. Now, the program that I'm going to share with you is called Links to Funds. And so if you are interested and you have some type of civic organization, or if you just have a specific cause that you're trying to generate income for, what better way to do that and get some of that money back that you got going out of your pocket anyway? Okay, so I have a few slides, if we can get the slides up, that I want to show you very quickly.
Can we
turn the light up just a bit, please? Okay, go ahead to the first slide. And you would ask, why would anybody want to do this? Well, you know, this is a lot better, if you get on the arrows, yeah, there you go. You went way ahead there, if you go back, please. If we would ask why anyone would want to do this, well, it's better to do this and have you dig a little bit deeper in your pocket to try to get money that you really don't have. But if you have money that you're spending, and we can show you how you can save money on any of your services that you currently use, then why not participate in the program? Now, our company was founded in 2001. We're located in Rochester, New York. And the co-founders, which is Craig Jerebeck, Jeff Tyler, and Jason Gubb, have put their experience together to develop this company, having worked for other large corporations before themselves. And so they have over 60 years of experience in marketing and telecommunications. Now, we've experienced over 800% growth in a down economy. And of course, recently we just built a new 50,000 square foot world headquarters, and they put the representatives first because we're the guys here on the ground I said the battlefield, that's actually bringing customers in to help people. It's all about helping people save money. Next slide, please. Okay. Now, when we talk about can you go back?
Sure.
Just one. Okay, when we talk about the credibility of the company, we are an Inc. 500 company. And we deal with a lot of Fortune 500 companies as well with the products and services that we offer. We're not coming out with anything new that you don't use already. And you already know the companies that you're paying these monthly bills to anyway. And so we're well documented. And of course, we've been Inc. 500 consecutively since 2006, I believe it says over there. And we just recently were featured in their magazine again for 2012. Success from magazine, which Darren Hardy is the publisher of that, was at our last convention that we just had in New Orleans. And a wonderful guy. And the only way that you're gonna get in that magazine is that you gotta be having some success. Okay, and then of course, you know, your Business from Home magazine, which is what I have in my hand here. And so this opportunity, go to the next slide, allows the average person that may not have transportation or educational skills, because this is a level playing field. You don't need to have any special skills or knowledge or education to participate in it. And that's what excited me, because it gives an opportunity to empower those people that may feel they have to have certain educational skills or intelligence or tools and things like that to do this. And it's a real simple, easy thing to do. Now, what I'm showing you here is just some of the deregulated things that have taken place along this timeline that we missed when the computers were just coming out. You know, before that, we were all using encyclopedias and typewriters, would you agree?
Yes.
Okay, and then of course, with the deregulation of the phone company, that was a real big thing that we didn't have to make all these high charges for long distance calls. And then of course, when the internet came out, World Book Encyclopedia basically went out of business, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely.
Okay, but now we're in the 2000s where we actually have a voice over internet protocol, what we call digital phone service, and we also now have deregulation of energy, the last giant fall. And so I want to talk, as you go to the next slide, please, I want to talk a little bit more about the voice over internet protocol, because VoIP allows us now to cut our phone service in half, up to 50% or more. And so if you can save that, our church bill went from $800 a month down to $166 a month, simply by using the phone service over the internet. And it's the same quality. So who wouldn't want to save? Anybody here? Okay, and this is for your business or your home, okay? So what we're seeing is 44 million U.S. households this year are going to be on this service, and we know that's going to increase. Also, we also have another feature called GSP10 that you can make phone calls right from your computer. So you can take that with you wherever you go. It's good for residential and commercial usage. And then we have a mobile app for your cell phone, okay, that you can actually make video calls from your cell phone. And then, of course, this is our new multi-million dollar state-of-the-art network that we have. We also provide the equipment if needed. Next slide. Okay, now the big thing that I'm excited about, again, the last giant to fall is energy. Many of us here in the local area are kind of subject to whatever Memphis Light, Gas, and Water wants to do with us. Okay, so we never know from 1 year or 1 day or 1 month to the next what we're going to be paying. But with competition coming in now, it's going to, of course, drive costs down. And with the other companies that are out there, since all this energy is on the same grid, it's going to make prices more affordable for us. This is 10 times the size of telecom. The monopolies have been broken up, mandated by the government. We have 17 states yet, and we're still waiting on Tennessee to come out. We haven't been rolled out yet, but beware, it's coming. This is for natural gas and electricity, and this industry is a $500 billion industry. How much of that would you like to get paid on?
$2 billion.
That's great. Why not the whole thing? Well, okay. Can we get to the next slide, honey?
I'm trying.
Okay. Okay. Did you pass the slide? Let's look at one time. I think there's a little cycle in there. Go back for me. if you just get on that yellow.
Just being a little slow.
Okay, go ahead.
Is that the one that you need, or?
Pastor Burnett, while they're pulling that up for you, can we dial in here for a second? One of the things that we're doing is
up and down arrow.
You have the capabilities, every business in here,
is that the one he needs?
To sit down with these business owners.
Yes.
And do an analysis of all the bills you're already paying. Now, this doesn't mean, you know, some of you may want to go into being an independent consultant here. But where we come in is that we're offering you this free analysis of whether or not you can get a discount on the services you're paying for, whether it's Verizon Telephone, whether it's DirecTV, dish service.
It's a universe.
There you go. So with the professional membership, which is $100 a year, this is an option of one of our reviews. And I forget what you called it. We're still working on that.
I call it essential services consultant.
Essential services review is what you'll get, an online review of your bills and what kind of discount you can get by paying those bills through B.W.Burnett, okay, and his business. Now, when you pay those bills through there and get your discount, because they'll show you the before and the after if you were to do this, then that goes toward assisting the ministry and the community. Does it make sense?
Yes.
Okay, I wanted to make that clear to everyone.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you so much. And this is where I was going to tie that in. On each of these services up here, whether it's a home alarm system, whether it's a cell phone, we also have another feature called text alert. If you would very quickly take your cell phones out for me. Take your cell phones out. And what I want you to do is see what I've done for BOCI. Okay? And what you're going to do is in your telephone area, like you send a regular text message, okay, you're going to put a short code, 55469. 55469. And in the message area, put BOCI. Doesn't matter if it's uppercase, lowercase, one letter, capitalized, it doesn't matter. Just put BOCI and hit send. And you're going to get a message back.
What was that?
55469 is the telephone number.
55469?
55469, yes. And then B, Bravo, Oscar, Charlie, India. BOCI.
Does it need to be capital, lower?
It doesn't matter. It does not matter.
Is that on the number?
Say that again, please. Okay. Yes, just like that. And send. And you should get a message back. Along with that message, you can also have a link that'll take you right to the OCI's website.
And you did this for us this morning without me knowing. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay. So we have a lot of features that can actually help your business and promote your business. But we're going to help you save money on everything that you're currently spending money on. Okay? Now, if you want to do this as a business, that's fine. But I want to show you how, as a business, that you can actually assist us with reaching people that are in dire need of assistance in ministry. Okay? So can we go to the next slide? Oh, and I heard you said, you guys said you're in real estate. You know, for every home you sell, I mean, you already have worked with that client. You know what they need. This can be a big help to them to do an analysis of the services they're going to get anyway. You can become a one-stop shop for them. Okay? So go ahead, pass this, honey, because I'm just going to jump through this real quick so we can, if anybody wants to know about the comp plan, they can talk to me. Okay, go ahead. It's about residual income. So. Okay. One more time, honey. One more time, please.
On a roll.
One more time. Okay, this is just a photo of some people from every walk of life that you can possibly imagine that did this on a part-time basis. Okay, as a pastor, when I tried to work a full-time job, it really took me away from what I'm very passionate about. And that's being in the community, touching people, talking to them, visiting the sick, and things of this nature. Doing a regular job, it kind of hampered my efforts a little bit. and I had to get permission. And people were saying, well, look, do you want to work or do you want to do that? So it kind of put me where I had to walk into the job and take that leap that we talked about, you know, of faith to do something like this. Next slide.
Next.
Okay. What we do, should you decide to look at this as a business opportunity, it comes with a complete training program. Business plan is already done for you. Everything's done. We have an online training university for you to learn more about the company, products, and services, and how it help people save money. You'll have two websites. One is a business reporting, and the other is your personal website for the products and services. And we're going to give you our personal website. So if you want to go out there and just look at what we have out there, and we're going to give you our business card and so forth, you can contact us. And we want to partner with you as we try to change our city, change our communities, and especially the younger generation coming up, that we can be role models for them. Okay? I thank you so much for your time and attention today, and God bless y'all, okay?
And it's a pleasure to be able to collaborate with you to make a difference in our community. I love to give back. So everyone, you can see Pastor B.W.Burnett to get a free analysis. So we now are ready for another demo. All right. Before I announce that, I'm going to do like American Idol now. They get you all excited and then, okay. I would like you all to stand, find somebody you have talked to, network for 60 seconds, and the next voice you will hear will be Miss Jana Cardona.
Okay, I'm trying to put your information on here about the website. So is that it right here? Is that it right here?
Okay. Here, why don't you try it now? You saw like I just want to come to the YouTube. Hi. It just kept falling out.
So you'll just announce that?
Yeah.
And you're the direct pastor a lot. Okay.
While you're writing this, I'm going to finish talking to the next one. Okay, so what do I need right now?
What I'm doing. It's like when I come to writing this, I'm going to
laptop charger, even though we already have a lot of those big problems.
That way, you
have your own channel. Is the sound system going to be on?
She's probably chilling out her
actual headphones.
Okay, 60 seconds is up.
I know, and I
promised to mom. I know that's something I would want to do.
All right, everybody, real quick. If I do not have your business card, I need it. Come and give it to me right now. I've got Tracy Lynn Jewelry, Renee Smith, I've got Carolyn Bendel, I've got Melissa James. Business card. I've got Mia Earle. I've got business card. I've got Why. Joy Finn Company. I've got Donna. I've got Cheryl Hurley, and I've got Will Reed, and we've got Marlon McKelvey, and
Gina.
Can you just write your name down on something? If you don't have a card, we're doing a door prize. We've got Gina Davis. We've got B.W.Burnett. Y'all stay in case you win the, can you stay
okay,
long enough
yes,
to win the pick?
Uh-huh.
And we've got Jana Cardona. Is that everybody? I do have her card. Thank you. All right, so let's see. Sarah, would you come up and draw a card? And this first door prize is going to be, I'll tell you in a minute. There we go. I've got the train. Drum roll. Oh, Cheryl Hurley just won a color analysis by Carolyn Bendel.
Cool.
All right, so if you'll hand that to Cheryl, and I'll hand this to you. Thank you, Fashion Academy. All right, and we have one more door prize to give out. All right. Oh, Melinda. Melinda Reed just won a headshot by Caroline, who has her own photography company. All right, and she just getting started doing a fabulous job. She did our Christmas photos, but she doesn't have business cards yet. So get with her.
She's talk to me.
She's on the BOCI profile.
Yes, she is on the BOCI profile.
Yes, but I have a referral for her, and I need a business card.
We need a business card. Yes. So let's make that happen.
I made them up this week.
All right. I'm passing this around as Jana Cardona is coming forward. We have 25 minutes, and she's got 20, so we're doing great. We're right on schedule. We want to thank Pastor B.W. Burnett and his lovely wife. They're going to have to leave early today. But thank you so much for coming out. I am passing this around. This is what you would sit down with Pastor B.W. Burnett to fill out. You can just kind of glance at it. It's not something they're going to give you. But this would be to get your discounts on your services. Not to go into the business, but to rather give back to the community by getting discounts. Now, last but not least, drum roll. Where's that new book? I don't know.
Business Networking Grow.
There we go. I like this. Jana Cardona. Am I saying your name right?
You are.
Okay. I had it spelled Cardona the last time.
Somebody it was.
Said,
C-A-R.
Somebody said it's Cardona. So for the longest I called you that. I apologize. But it is such an honor to have you here. Jana, as I said, is the director of the entire Mid-South of BNI, which is Business Network International. How many of you are BNI members? Okay, good. So you can attest to how great it is. And Jana is just, I can't say enough to say that I'm so excited that we're in collaboration, that you would come here. I plan to go to BNI after this event. And we can work together. So the ball's yours.
Okay. Well, I'm very excited to be working with Sherry. Heard about her, and we got together and spoke, and anyway, I think we can work together really well. It's very exciting to be able to. Because I'm all about collaboration. She's all about collaboration. I feel like I'm talking just to this side of the room. But anyway, this is a great opportunity for us to work together because BNI stands for Business Network International. And it's been around for 27 years. So I wish I had founded it. It was 27 years ago, founded by Dr. Ivan Meisner. And the book that started it was this little book in the middle called Giver's Game. And that tells the story of BNI. He was a business consultant, and he lost a major client. And he decided that, and so that he could eat, he was going to have to rebuild his business. And so he got with some of his friends and decided they would work together to network and to build each other's businesses back up and give each other referrals. And he didn't intend it to be anything but just a collaboration among friends. And what happened was they started to work together, started to talk about each other's businesses, get to know each other's businesses, and they started passing referrals. And other people found out about it, came to the group and said, hey, can we join you? And what they had decided to do was not compete. So if there was an image consultant, there wouldn't be two image consultants, so that that person could get referrals. So the people said, well, can you help us start one? And they said yes, and so they started another one and then another one, and you know, it kept on going like that. And that's how BNI started. It wasn't intentional. And now it's in 51 countries. So if you go to Vietnam, you can go to BNI. If you go to France, you can go to BNI. And they continue to add new countries. It's a franchise. And so every one of the regions is run independently, but under a system. BNI has an overarching brand and a system that it follows, just like Starbucks or McDonald's, wherever you go in the world. I lived in Australia for 5 years. McDonald's looks the same. They make milkshakes different, though. They really don't make milkshakes. They put milk in a cup, and they put about that much ice cream, and it sort of twirls around a little bit. Yeah. And it doesn't taste like milkshake, you know. And we had this one place that we went, and it was a cafe, and they had up on their board one day American milkshakes. And I was like, oh, yay, American milkshakes, you know, that was great. And he had this machine that he had brought over from the United States, and he goes, this is an American machine. I can make American milkshakes. And he did for the longest time, and we used to go over there and get those milkshakes, because at McDonald's and some of those other places, they didn't make American milkshakes. And one day we went there and he had it crossed off, and we're like, what happened to your milkshake? Because I burned up my machine. So I guess he was adding a little too much ice cream for those of us Americans that like thick milkshakes. But it was funny, that's the only milkshake we could get when we lived over there. But in Australia, there's BNI's. I wasn't a part when I lived in Australia. But my responsibility with BNI, I love it, because it's kind of like, we were in ministry for 29 years, my husband was, before we went into self-employment and business. And so BNI is kind of like that to me, because I love helping people. I like working with people. And what we do is we form chapters. And we have 13 form chapters right here in this region. I have 5 in Mississippi. And my responsibility is to build the region and to add more chapters, because we don't have the ability to put you into a chapter if we've already got somebody that does your specialty. Now, I say specialty, because professions, it doesn't make a difference. We have a chapter that Sherry's going to visit, I think, if she can get out of here on time, to go to, that has 2 financial advisors in it. And talk about collaboration, they do. Because they've decided to niche, and in today's market, that's smart. Because there's a lot of one-stop shops, and so a lot of people do multiple businesses under one umbrella. And it's very hard for those of us helping them market to understand the full concept of everything that they do. And so what we're trying to help BNI members to do is to niche to where you come into BNI, and now Shelley's chapter, they have 2 CPAs. One specializes in taxes, which we would typically think of a chapter a CPA person would take. The other one does not like to do taxes. And so he focuses more on, I believe it's nonprofits and being a CFO for companies. And so he has his niche, and the other guy has his niche, and they both exist. And they don't—they learn to collaborate, even though they're both licensed the same way. We have attorneys that do the same thing, and those 2 financial advisors that do the same thing. But one focuses on more of the health benefits, health insurance part of his business, and the other one focuses on the investment side. So that's how we operate a chapter. And if somebody can't get into a chapter, that's how we end up starting new chapters. And I just came back from Tupelo yesterday. We have 2 chapters in Tupelo, and I'm building a 3rd. So when we can't have people that get into them, they ask that we build another chapter, which we do. So we'll probably build about between 3 and 6 this year in the Memphis area, and then another 2 or 3 down in the Mississippi area. But my responsibility is to help business owners form these chapters and then they work together to help build their business. And what we do is we meet weekly. BNI has a system, so we follow a structured system. So no matter where you go in the world, if you don't speak that language, you still know where you are on the agenda. We follow an agenda. It's kind of like the Starbucks coffee recipe. They don't change it, because if they did, you wouldn't be drinking Starbucks, you know? Mm-hmm. If you change the BNI agenda, you don't have a BNI. So it's based on a structure, a set structure. We do have accountability, and that's one thing we're known for, is that we do hold you accountable. As a business professional, you're in business. And so if we form teams of individuals, and if you're on a team, ball team, you have to be there. You have to be there to practice, you have to be there for the game. You can't just sort of decide that, oh, I don't feel like going today. We actually have an attendance policy. We're one of the few networking groups that does. But we expect you to be there. And the chapter expects you to be there. Now, we do accept absences, and we have a substitute program, that we can do if you have an engagement or you're sick or something like that. So we're not hardcore, but we do expect you to be professional. And we do expect you to be there because this is your team. So every week you come prepared to speak about your business. So you're going to give, some chapters as they grow, they have to shorten the time that you get to advertise. And so some of them are 45 seconds, some of them are 60 seconds. Typically it's 60, but it shortens down a little bit. Our chapters that are over 60 usually have like 30 to 40 seconds to do that. So you learn really well how to talk about your business in a short period of time and make it happen. And we try and work with them on learning how to represent their business, not just about what you do, because it's interesting, but we can know what you do and still not know who you need. So I'm trying to work with them on teaching them, tell me who you need, because this is your marketing team. And we are listening to you, we are hearing and hoping to write down what you say. And then what we want to do is, while we're out with our own clients, we know what you want. We've written it down. We hear what you say. You've given us maybe a specific person you want, specific company you want, so that you actually name what you're after. And then while we're out with our clients, I'm trying to help them to see, don't just wait till a referral smacks you in the face, you know, like, hey, do you know a good realtor? You know, not very many people talk about anything like that. They're talking about their own things. But we learn how to ask questions. We learn how to ask for them to say, you know, I have a business team I work with, and I'm going to use Shelly because she's sitting right here, and maybe Shelly talked about a company that she wanted. And I don't know that company. Maybe I have no dealings with it, but I want to help Shelly. She's on my team. So when I'm out with my clients and customers, I'm going to ask, you know, one of my business partners in one of my referral teams needs an introduction to XYZ company, and they need to speak to, you know, Ken Jones. I don't have any connections. Do you happen to know anyone? If I ask that enough times, and if everybody in the chapter does, guess what? Shelly's going to get the chance. That's how we work. Very deliberate networking. That we do very deliberate marketing for each other. It's based on the philosophy of giver's gain. So I come into a chapter, and I'm expected to, one of my expectations is to get referrals. I want them. Everybody in here, Sherry asked, how many want to make money? Anybody not want to make money? None of us, you know, we're all in business to eat and to provide for our family. So we want to make money, but you don't come into BNI thinking about, I'm going to get a lot of referrals. If you do that, guess what? Our little radar goes up because we're based on giver's gain, and we sense that as being selfish, and we don't do it. But if you come in and you give, and, you know, Pastor Burnett's a real good example of that. He's giving back to Orange Mount, his community, in a wonderful way. He cares about the people that he's serving. You get that kind of heart, you want to help them. You know, and that's what we do. We're listening for you, but we also know you're listening for us. And so we work together just like a team, just like a ball team where everybody has a piece. Everybody has a, I'm not a ball person, so what do you call it?
Like
you have a strategic place you play. What is that?
Position.
Yeah, a position. See, I don't do ball. But you have a position you play. If you don't play that position well, that team hurts. Or if you're not there, that team hurts. So that's kind of where we go. There's a lot more, and I don't know what time I have. I'm used to having a timer in front of me at BNI, and so somebody has to go.
You have 10 more minutes.
Oh, good, okay. And I'll leave some time for questions. But I wanted to let you know there's some things about BNI that benefits besides referrals. Yes, referrals are important, and referrals are what we're there for. And if you don't get referrals, chances are you want to leave. However, BNI is an active form of marketing. It is not passive. You can buy advertising, and that's wonderful, and you should have it. But that's passive. You pay someone to do it for you. You expect them to be professional, and you don't really have to do much. It goes on the air, and you know they do their job, and if they do it well, you're going to get some exposure. However, if you choose word of mouth marketing, guess who's involved? You know? And so you have to learn how to be a word of mouth marketer. It's not passive in any sense of the word. So we have a lot of education. We have a website, bni.com, where Dr. Meisner, who is the founder, who's an international speaker, he's known all over the world as the father of modern networking. We didn't call him that. CNN, Fox, they all call him that. He's a best-selling author about 17 times over. These are just a few of the books. He provides that for BNI members. He has a podcast that we can go and listen to for free. Every week, it's provided some kind of networking education. I provide education on a once a month, sometimes twice a month basis, based on that, because I do also have a speaking company outside of BNI that I'm working with companies to train them on networking. And that's something I'm passionate about because I've had to do it for 15 years. And I love it, and so I want to help others. So we have lots of different ways that we can educate our members how to do things to present themselves. So they learn that. We have some people come into BNI who are so afraid to talk. And guess what? You know, I can honestly relate to that because when I was in high school, you know those yearbooks where they will things to other people? My shyness was willed to the people behind me. I was so embarrassed. I don't show anybody. I don't show anyone my high school yearbook. Because, you know, I've come a long way, baby. Maybe that's the best way to put it. Because I've learned, and thankfully part of that's learning how to be in front of people and network and being pushed, you know, sometimes to do things. Well, some of our BNI members come in and they're like so afraid to stand up and talk, and they don't. But what's nice is that everybody on that team is like real supportive. So they're like, come on, you know, you can do it. They'll fill in words for this person. And pretty soon you go back a couple months later and you're like, who is that? It's not the same person. They feel comfortable. They feel like this team supports me. They care about me and they feel better. So it's all about that. So you learn to be a better person. You learn how to think about other people a lot. And if you're kind of come in with an attitude of I'm in it for me, you soon change that. Or they weed you out if you don't, but you learn how to adapt to that. You learn about collaboration, and that's one thing that I really like about Sherry and the things that she's doing, and that's why we've talked a lot and working together, because I'm all for that. And I love what she does, and I think we can do a lot together with BNI and BOC as a part of that. And there's just a lot of things. You learn to develop a family. We had, Sherry, what's the time?
You've got about 5 minutes.
Okay. We had a guy who owned a Service Master franchise, and he got sick, like out of the blue. He was fine, then he was sick, and found out he had leukemia. And this was a couple years ago, and he had his wife, and he was the tech because they were just starting out. And so what happened was he had to go through chemo. He was in the hospital a lot. And so the BNI members in his chapter, plus the whole of BNI, the event Sherry was talking about, we had one of those right after we found out about him being sick. So his chapter put together a picture of his family, put it out there with a poster. We put some donation box there, and we had this event, and people donated. But this was really the best part. The chapter rallied around him and helped with the business, and another service master person, who's a competitor, stepped in and did all this work, and then gave him the money to help pay for medical bills. That's the kind of family that we developed in the office. And you know, he's right now, he's doing well, he's kind of come through his cancer, so do you have a comment on that?
No, although I thought it was totally awesome and very, you know, giving from the heart. But I want you to tell everybody about the networking event.
Yes, yes. we do have a networking event come up, and my BNI people scare me to death because they take forever to sign up and do things. But we have a we're renting the Brain Hall, which is in Germantown. If you know where the facility is, that's the GPAC, kind of on the other end of that. And we have this once a year. It's in line with International Networking Week, which BNI started several years ago. We're trying to, you know, make it all over the world. So we're trying to do that. But we're inviting everyone. So I'd love for the BOC people to come and bring your friends.
And
because it's free. It's free to you. What we do is we pay for it by having sponsor booths from our BNI members. You have to be a BNI member to be a booth holder. But we also have restaurants that, and if you know a good restaurant that would like advertising, we give them a free space in return for they do the little Costco type samples, you know, where you get a bite of their food. And so we have restaurants like Genghis, Bangkok Galley, Panera, some of those others are going to participate. They like it because it gives them the ability to get in front of business people who take people out to lunch and dinner or whatever. But we have a great time. We network. I don't do any speeches, nothing like that, because people just want to talk. And so we get a lot of opportunity to meet a lot of different people and learn to make new contacts. And so I'd love for you to come. It is Monday, February 4th. From 5 to 8 at the Great Hall. It's right on Germantown Road. If you're going north on Germantown Road, it'll be on the right after you pass Farmington. And where the tennis courts are, just there's a parking lot right there. You go in. We would love for you to come invite your friends. If you know good restaurants, please let me know, because we'd love them to be a part. Does anyone have any questions as I wrap it up? I invite you to visit a BNI chapter. There's a couple of BNI members here. They can invite you to it. And
everybody come out to Arlington.
Yeah. Gina's in Arlington and Shelly's across the
club
street.
Just before BOCI, so often you'll see that I'm slipping in late.
That's right. Marlon's over at DeVry.
There's one in the loop. I'm going to.
There's one in the loop you're going to. So any of those, you can go on. And the website's on my card. You can visit. Just call me. I'd love to help you out and just go visit sometime and get to know some of these people. Thanks so much. It's great to be here, and I love being here, and I'm looking forward to more opportunities to work with everyone here. Thank you.
Excellent. Are these books for sale as well?
They are. Okay. Some of them I've written in, so you can.
Okay. All right. I would like to bring Pastor Renee Smith up, and would you bring one of your pieces?
Okay.
We're wrapping up. We have 5 minutes, and so this is something that all of you have access to. You can rent a table for $25 if you are a professional member, and I just love. If you knew which one to bring, didn't you? This is so pretty. So as you see, there's beautiful pieces over here. Tell us again the starting prices on up. So people look at this and probably think, well, that's $150, but it's only
$36.
Wow.
Again, this is Tracy Lynn Fashion Jewelry, and our jewelry is affordable and gorgeous. Our starting price is $16 around for the earrings, and then the highest price is probably about $50, something like that. And today I'm doing everything 25% off. I would love to just let it stay here. I prophesy to the jury, you cannot come home all the time.
All right, thank you so much. We're so happy to have you here and have you as a part of BOCI.
Okay.
Right, so you'll get a chance to go over there in just a moment. And Beverly Borick, would you go on and grab your jewelry, come up, and while we're waiting on you, Cheryl, would you walk back to your table so everybody knows where to find you about blogging and your all the different services that you offer through the Stylist Quo. And now, real quick, come up here and do your show and tell, Beverly. Beverly, I'm so proud of. She does beautiful pieces. Sarah, you can testify to her pieces. Would you say a little something about the pieces you wear?
The colors are amazing. They go with absolutely everything. And they're just very nice jewelry.
Handmade.
Custom design.
Yeah, custom design.
I have a testimonial.
Uh-huh.
She will actually sit down with you and design a piece of jewelry for you. Yeah. For over the holidays, I wanted to give one of my good friends a very beautiful gift, and we sat down and we designed it together, and then she crafted it, and I haven't actually given it to her yet because Okay, not together, but she, I know she's gonna love it.
And I made two styles.
Yes, you made two styles.
So. Good deal. So here's what I see. I see Pastor Renee over here, and I see you over here, Beverly.
We're totally different.
And you're totally different. I see collaboration. So y'all get together and do a little talking, all right? Okay, everybody stand. Everybody find somebody you haven't found yet. Talk to them. Drop by the table over there. Sign up for your review if you are a professional member. We have 6 reviews available.
I don't know.